Hey, what's up? It's your boy Vonnie Hudson with securityplusPro.com and welcome to this quick video. I'm going to show you six ways that you need to know to pass the CompTIA SY0-501 exam. No bull, no crap. Let's jump right into it. Okay, the number one thing you need to be aware of first, so this is kind of like tip number zero, is that the test is composed of 90 questions and you get 90 minutes apiece for each question. Now, I'm no mathematician, but 90 questions, 90 minutes, that means 1 minute per question. And before you panic, don't worry, all the questions aren't weighted equally. So, you know, some questions will take longer, some questions will take less. And so you don't need to feel like, you know, you need to rush to the test that way. Now, the first tip that I'm gonna give you is actually related to questions. And that is, you wanna make sure that you answer the performance-based questions last. So when you're taking a test, you'll run into scenario-based questions. And they typically involve a greater time investment. And so, because in the CompTIA Security Plus exam, you don't have to go sequentially, you can mark a question and then go back to it later. You should just mark the performance-based questions, return to it later, and then continue going forward with the multiple choice questions, which are a lot easier to answer. And the same goes for any questions that you're trying to answer that you're not really sure of. Just mark them and then move forward. So the test is actually graded on a scale from 1 to 900. A 750 is the minimum passing mark, which is roughly around 82, I think it's 82.5. And that's what you want to aim for, okay? You want to make sure you at least get a 750. Okay, so let's jump right into the tips. Sorry, excuse me for that. Let's jump into the tips. Tip number one, look at the CompTIA Security Plus objectives. So if you go to the Security Plus objective site, and all these links are gonna be included in the show in the notes below, you can see what the objectives are for the exam. Now, if you scroll down, you'll see that there are primarily six domains. These are six areas of study that you need to be concerned of. The first are threats, attacks, and vulnerabilities, okay? That's gonna be 21% of the test. But the largest share of questions are actually devoted to technologies and tools. And that's at 22%. And that's because the CompTIA SY0-501 has a stronger focus on hands-on experience. And you'll notice that that's one of the chief differences between the 501 and the 401. There's a stronger emphasis on hands-on, there's a stronger emphasis on risk management, risk mitigation, and also cloud-based technology. So there is a 25% difference between the 501 and the 401, but that's the chief one that you really need to take into consideration, are the hands-on tools. Hands-on experience that you're gonna need with the tools. There's also architecture and design at 15%, there's identity and access management at 16%, and then you have risk management at 14%, and then cryptography and public key infrastructure at 12%. And if you scroll down this document, you'll see everything is laid out to you in a really easy to digest format. You've got spear phishing, right? You've got distributed denial of service, you've got gray box penetration testing concepts, encapsulating security payload. You know, there's a lot of stuff here. Passive versus active scanning. You know, there's a lot of stuff here. And if you really just go through the sheet, which is completely free, you have your notes, right? This is your outline that you need to follow. And it's completely free. I don't know if a lot of people realize this, but now you do. So remember where you got this from, okay? And if you even scroll down further, you have a bunch of acronyms. So AV, asset value. It's also antivirus. And there's a bunch of acronyms here, completely free. Make sure you start memorizing these acronyms. And if I were you, I would actually take this sheet and I would print it out because it's just extremely valuable and it's free. So that's awesome, okay? So let's move into the number two thing you need to be aware of. Number two, you're gonna wanna schedule the exam 90 days out. Now this is gonna sound really crazy, but it's been statistically shown that those students who schedule the exam 90 days out, even before they are confident that they can actually take the test and pass it, are those who actually pass it. And I think part of the rationale there is because if you're willing to take that investment of time and money because you're scheduling the exam, you're gonna bust your balls or your ovaries if you're a girl to pass that freaking exam, okay? So it's a little risky, but I encourage you to do this. Now what you're gonna do is you're gonna go to the CompTIA website, all these exams are down below in the notes, and you're gonna wanna do four things. First, you create the Pearson VUE testing account, then you find the testing center, you schedule the exam, and then you save the exam appointment confirmation. Trust me on this one, guys. If you do this, you're gonna put yourself a step above the rest. Let's look at number three. Number three, make sure that when you're studying, you're actually using a recording device to record questions and answers. So you want to create a catalog of your own voice recording different questions. So ask yourself questions. For example, Vani, what's the difference between a firewall and a unified threat management system? A, B, C, and D, and whatever, and go through the list. And then record your answers and record your explanations and then save that as one file. And at the end of the day, you're going to have a bunch of files with questions and answers that will pretty much prepare you when you are on the subway or you're on the train, you're taking a commute into work, or maybe you're driving into work and you want to listen to it, you know, through Bluetooth on your car's headphones or your car's speakers. You're going to basically put yourself in a better position to pass the exam because you're going to be able to hear your own voice recording this, and it just makes a ton of a difference. I know it sounds crazy, just give it a shot. It will make a difference, okay? Number four, when you're taking the test, you can go forward and back. It's not entirely linear. So when you encounter performance-based questions, which require more concentration, more time, you can mark those questions. It's the same you can do with any questions that are hard that you might not know the answer to right away. Then do the easier multiple choice questions, and then when you have time at the end of the test, go back to the ones you marked and answer those later. This is a smart way to time yourself and pace yourself as you get through the exam. It'll give you more confidence, it'll give you more control, and ultimately a higher testing score, and that's what you want. Number five, you're gonna wanna go to securityplusprobe.com and check out our site. So we have tons of free content, resources, brain dumps, PDFs, video training that will take you step by step, A to Z, from beginning to end. It'll take you through a system that has been proven to get results. Okay, so you're gonna wanna go to the site, make sure you click on either get instant access to jump right into the free course, or you can go down to get some free Security Plus training. You can download some brain dumps. You can even, if you're overly ambitious and you wanna even get more in depth in your studies, you can go for our boot camp option. And the most important thing is that when you get to the bottom, you're gonna wanna click, yes, I want to subscribe. When you subscribe, we send you only that which is absolutely critical for you passing the exam. We're gonna send you training material. We're gonna send you PDFs. We're gonna send you cheat sheets. We're gonna send you the material that's been proven to give you what you need to pass the exam. So check out securityplusprobe.com and also check out our blog. You can see here's a blog that hasn't even been posted yet, but this is an article on using the command prompt, and you can see pretty much what it looks like. There's different commands you can type and different screenshots. I explain what ARP is, everything is here. It's really awesome. Some of the posts are a little longer than normal, but you know, when you read through it, make sure you know you go ahead and then you know subscribe, and we'll send you everything you need to pass the exam, okay? So that is number five now. Lastly, number six, subscribe to the channel. You'll get the latest updates, everything you need right here on the YouTube channel, so subscribe. Now finally, I just wanna finish off everything with a few questions that people have that I've heard about this new test. Some people say, well, Vani, is the SY0-501 harder than the SY0-401? It's not necessarily harder, it's just different, right? There's a 25% difference between both tests, and the newer exam has a stronger focus on risk mitigation and hands-on technology, so you're gonna wanna put your focus there as well. The other thing I've heard is if you have an existing certification, such as a Network Plus, that's expiring, and you've taken past the Security Plus, does it renew your Network Plus? The answer is yes. In fact, you can go to CompTIA's website and you can see that's exactly how this works. If you've earned multiple CompTIA certifications, then the CE program, the continuing education program, enables you to keep all of your approved certifications by renewing your highest level CE. So you renew the Security Plus, you also get the Network Plus thrown in. So that's pretty cool. The other time, another question I've heard is, you know, I've studied for the SY0-401, should I just stop my studies and now go to the 501? I would say no. Well, it depends on when you're watching this video, because the SY0-401 is actually gonna be valid until July 31st, 2018. Therefore, if you've already started studying for that, continue down that path and you know, don't worry about the 501. Now, if you haven't started studying yet, jump into the 501. It's new, it's ready for you, and now is a better time than ever for you to jump into that. Okay, so if you have any other questions, make sure you leave a comment below. Make sure you subscribe to this channel, thumb up this video, check out securityplusprobe.com, check out the blog, and I look forward to seeing you there. Thank you so much for giving me this time to share this information with you. I really appreciate it, and all the best of luck for you on your testing studies.